Have you ever looked at the night sky and wondered, where did the moon go? Me too. I'm Emily and I don't work for NASA. I'm just a homeschool mom and I want to share with you what I've learned about the moon.
Yeah, moon. Where is that? What is that? What is that?
As a girl, I was always fascinated with the moon and wondering why some nights I could see it and why sometimes it was during the day and what was a new moon. I thought for a really long time a new moon was a full moon, and I've been relearning all this stuff with my girls in their science curriculum and I love it, so I'm going to show you. In a minute, I'm going to show you how the moon phases work, but first we're going to go over some terminology. If you're interested in more videos about parenting and homeschooling and just general family fun life content, be sure you subscribe, hit like, and get the bell on so that you get notified when we have really cool content coming up. All right, interesting fact, the moon makes one complete rotation for every rotation of the Earth, so that is why we always see the same side of the moon. Stay tuned to the end of this video to see details on how you can win this painting. First up, we have the new moon. Now, contrary to what I thought as a girl, this does not mean the same thing as a full moon. In fact, the new moon, or the starting of the new lunar phase, is when we cannot see the moon at night because it is not there. The moon is hiding in plain sight during broad daylight. We can't see the reflection of the sun now because the moon is between the Earth and the sun. The moon will set around the same time the sun sets that evening. Like a bud that hasn't flowered yet, the moon is renewing. Now, think of a candle being dipped and dipped repeatedly in wax as it grows in diameter. The moon waxes. After the new moon, the waxing crescent moon can start to be seen in the afternoon and evening. This is often what gets referred to as the Cheshire Cat moon. The moon continues to wax till it is one quarter full or first quarter. I'll explain why this is in a moment, but you'll note that it looks half full with the light reflecting off the western side of the moon. After the moon is a quarter full or half moon, it gets really bent out of shape. What we can see reflected is a football shaped and called a gibbous, and it's neither round nor half nor crescent shaped. Now it is rising later and later in the day. Now the moon is full. We see the full reflection on the face of the moon, and now we are between the moon and the sun. The atmosphere and optical illusion will make the rising moon look big and yellow as it rises after the sun sets. The moon rises an hour later every night as it begins to wane. Because the moon takes approximately 28 plus days to make a full cycle from new to new, that means there is usually one full moon a month. But things can get real interesting when there are 13 full moons in a year, resulting in a blue moon. A true blue moon is when there is a fourth full moon in between any given equinox and solstice, but it can also be defined as a moon happening twice in 1 month. Now the moon begins to wane. The waning gibbous appears to lose its energy and diminish into the night, rising later and later at night. You might catch a glimpse of the last quarter moon rise in the early dark hours of the morning and see it set in the afternoon. The waning crescent moon sleepily sets in the evening with the reflected light on its eastern left side. And then it's reborn anew and begins the cycle all over again. And there you have the moon phases. Now let me show you what it looks like as if you were a spaceship looking down on the North Pole of the Earth. I'm going to be using this handy wheel I made to point out the perspectives of the moon. Be sure to look for the weather chart video that explains how I made this moon dial board in the description below. Here's the sunlight. Here's the Earth. The moon goes around the Earth counterclockwise. These larger moons are what we see, but the inner moons are what is actually happening. When we see the waxing crescent moon, it has just as much sunlight on it as a full moon, but we can only just see the little sliver of it. When we see a half moon,
we can only see one quarter of the moon. But technically speaking, the full moon is when we actually see the full half of the moon, and the last quarter moon is three quarters full.
And here is the finished painting, and you have an opportunity to win this original painting. So we want to thank our subscribers. Right now we're at about 130, and we are so thrilled, and we love you guys and thank you so much. But we are trying to get to 500 subscribers, and if you like and share this, and you're entered for a chance to win this. And as soon as we get to that 500 mark, we'll announce the winners that we draw out of a hat. But there's a catch. You do have to comment below with an answer to the question of the day, a question in the video. You can get multiple entries by commenting on our other videos as well, so be sure to really stay tuned and be subscribed and hit that bell so that you know when there's going to be a question of the day. So today's question is, what is your favorite moon phase and why? If you want to support our channel, find our merchandise link in the description below. All right, so be sure to subscribe, hit the bell, like us, comment, find us on Facebook, stalk us on Instagram, all that jazz. And be sure to check out our videos over here, the one about how to make your own weather chart and the nature journaling one.